my troopers popping in this bitch, popping in this bitch. Me and my troopers popping in this bitch, popping in this bitch. Me and my troopers.
Birdman hands. Hello, my name is Mr. J3T, aka Big Sexy, aka the Kentucky Cannon, aka the World Class Badass, aka Big Daddy Long, aka Chocolate Thunder with the Caramel Swirl, aka Black Lightning with the Peanut Butter Filling, aka the Shaman of Sexy, aka the Houdini of Sexy, aka your real World Heavyweight Champion, just in case you forgot. And today, we're going to be talking about Blue Beetle. So, yeah, this is a bit of a DC-themed comeback. Last week, I talked about, last week I talked about my adventures with Superman. Now I'm talking about Blue Beetle. So, yeah, DC, yeah. So, Blue Beetle is the newest DCEU film to come out, and it's about the titular Blue Beetle. And Jaime Reyes. So Jaime Reyes, he just came back from college. He has some money issues. His family is about to get evicted from their house, and he's trying to get some money to basically help out his family to make sure they don't go out on the street, right? But then shenanigans ensue, and he ends up with the scarab that attaches itself to its back, to his back, and now he can have and forms this suit of armor around him. So now he's the Blue Beetle, and now he's got to deal with not only the scarab, this piece of alien tech literally attached to his spine, but he also has to deal with this company that wants to get the scarab back so they can make armies of suits and for war and so, you know, the usual evil company, war company in these movies, you know, the usual, y'all know the evil war companies. That's basically the gist of the movie. So right off the bat, I gotta say, this is one of the better DC movies that came out recently. I'd say this movie is up there with, like, the first Wonder Woman movie. What others? The Suicide Squad. Aquaman 1. Damn, I'm really trying to think if there are more good DC movies. Like, it's hard. I'm really trying to think. I don't think there's any more. Yeah, I think it's just Wonder Woman, the first one, the first Aquaman, the Suicide Squad, and I think that's it. Yeah, I think those are the only good ones. But yeah, I feel like Blue Beetle's up there with, like, the better DC movies that came out. This movie is very colorful. I liked how colorful and bright and vibrant everything was. Even, like I said with my last video about My Adventures with Superman, like, it's kind of a good change of pace from, like, the usual stuff DC does with, like, its color palettes, the very monotone, unsaturated color palettes, very dark color palettes. So I like that they're starting to become a little more brighter with the color palettes. That's one thing that I kind of liked about the Flash movie, is that I liked how bright and vibrant everything was. So I like pretty colors, what can I say? That's probably, which side note, that's probably the only thing you will ever hear me, the only time you will ever hear me praising the Flash movie, because I might do a video about it sometime, but, like, yeah, let's just say I wasn't a big fan. But enough about that movie, we're here to talk about Blue Beetle. So I liked the relationship between Jaime and the Scarab. I believe, I forget the scarab's name, but I think its name is Clara, I think. So, I like their relationship. I like how their relationship develops, like, I like how, basically, in the end, they're working together. They're, bantering with each other, working together, fighting together, you know, together. Like a perfect symbiosis. I like their relationship. I like how it developed throughout the film. I like how Jaime learns to embrace the scarab, because at first he's like, hey, get this thing off my back. But as the movie goes on, he learns to embrace it. And the scarab learns to embrace Jaime and eventually grow to care for Jaime a bit. Because there's one part where it actually apologizes to Jaime because at some point it couldn't protect him. So it grows to care about him a bit. So I liked seeing the relationship grow throughout the film. It's a less toxic version of Venom is the best way I can describe their relationship. Just, it's Venom, but less toxic. In fact, way less toxic. So that's the best way I can describe their relationship. And I liked it. I liked it. Speaking of the Blue Beetle suit, I liked the suit. I liked that they used a practical suit. A part of me thought that they were going to go the Spider-Man and the MCU route, where they just made the whole thing, at some points they would just turn the whole thing CGI, or a better example, I thought they were going to go the Green Lantern route, you know, that, you guys remember that Green Lantern movie with Ryan Reynolds? I thought they were going to go that route with just the entire CGI suit, but they didn't. Like, there were points where the actor, Jaime, is running in the suit, and it's practical, and it's one of the best-looking practical suits in a comic, in, like, comic book movies ever. One of the best-looking practical suits ever. Like, so they really did a great job with the suit, and I like that they took the practical route with it, because, again, a part of me was scared that they were gonna pull a Green Lantern and CGI the whole thing, but I'm glad that they didn't. I'm glad that they went the practical route, because it looks so much better. It looks so much better. The fight scenes, I really like the fight scenes in this. It's kind of like an upgrade. It's kind of like Upgrade in a sense. If, for those of you that don't know, Upgrade is about a guy who is wheelchair bound, and he gets a chip inserted into his back, his spine, and it allows him to walk, and he can give the chip control over his body, and the chip is moving him, and he moves all robotic like killing motherfuckers and shit. So for those of you that's watched Upgrade, y'all know what I'm talking about, but it's basically like that. There's a point where Jaime fights one of the big bads, the antagonist of the film, and, I wouldn't say villain, more of an antagonist. He fights the antagonist, who is basically the lapdog, slash bodyguard, slash servant of the real villain. So he fights the antagonist, and at one point the scarab asks him, hey, things are looking too good, you want me to take control? And Jaime's like, yes, please. And so the scarab takes control, and he starts kicking his ass, and it kind of reminded me of that. And near the end of the movie, where, you know, they're in sync, they're perfect together. So, you know, when they're in sync, the fights, I don't know how much of it is the scarab and how much of it is Jaime, but we get something similar where he fights a whole bunch of guards, and it's so cool. The fights are great in this movie. I'm 99% sure that the stunt guy that they got to do the fight scenes it Power Rangers, because like some of the fights in here and some of the poses that that guy would do was ripped straight out of Power Rangers. Like, if you watch the trailer, you'll see that one part in the trailer where Jaime makes that big ass sword and he like scrapes it on the ground and just puts it on his shoulder. Like, that was ripped straight out of Power Rangers. And the way the stunt guy just did it, and how he did it, and just how he posed and just did the it just felt so Power Rangers, and I liked it. Like, they turned Blue Beetle into a Power Ranger in this movie, and I loved it. I love Power Rangers, so therefore I loved all those parts, because yeah, I'm 99% sure that the stunt guy that they got to do the fight scenes, who was actually in the suit doing the fight scenes, I'm pretty sure he did Power Rangers at some point, because yeah, ugh, I loved it. Also, another part about that scene is when they're sync, they're like, hey, Jaime's like, hey, let's kick some ass, and the Scarab actually starts speaking Spanish, saying, yeah, let's do it, and I'm like, aw, that's sweet, the Scarab speaking Spanish, that's sweet. Like I said before, just Venom, but less toxic, you know. I was like, yeah, that's kind of sweet that the Scarab was speaking Spanish. So, yeah, I liked all the Blue Beetle stuff. As for the family stuff, I liked it too. His family was very fun. You know, his family was... They very much felt like a real family. Now, I'm obviously not Hispanic, but... So the family dynamics in here kind of reminded me a bit of my own family. It reminded me of my aunts and uncles, and specifically when the moment when the Scarab attached itself to Jaime's back and the way the family reacted, I was like, yeah, I can see my family reacting in the same way, especially my auntie. I could see a lot of my family reacting as how they reacted in the movie. So, I liked his family particularly. I liked George Lopez, the uncle, because George Lopez is a treasure. He's a national icon. He is a treasure, and I haven't seen George in a minute. I think we've all had that. All my 2000s kids out there, we've all had that moment where we woke up in the morning right as the George Lopez show theme song was playing. Like, it was never in the middle of the episode, it was never at the end of the episode, it was always the opening that you woke up to. All my 2000s kids out there, we have that same experience. So, it was cool seeing George Lopez in here. I haven't seen him in a minute, so it was fun seeing him. He was definitely, like, one of the funnier parts of the movie, one of the best parts of the movie, and he reminded me of, my Uncle Pee-wee a little bit. Yeah, so, I liked the family, I liked how they all bounced off of each other, I liked how real they felt at moments. I love how, yeah, I didn't get annoyed by them. I liked them, and that's really all I asked. None of them annoyed me. All of them came off endearing. I liked Jaime's relationship with his uncle. I liked his relationship with his dad, his sister. They felt like real siblings in the movie, which was cool. I liked them. Now, as for stuff that, like, I didn't really like that much, I would say the plot is a bit, generic. Like, you've seen this plot 1,000 times, like, you've know all of the everything that's about to happen in this movie, like, you could guess it. It's not a bad thing, necessarily, because, this movie's not trying to, like, be, Mozart or whatever, you know. It's just a fun superhero action movie, so it so it's not trying that obvious. It's obviously trying, but it's not trying like that hard. But I will say, things can feel a bit predictable, a little samey from other superhero movies that did this. I will say they did a good job making the main bad guy, the CEO of this company, unlikable. They really did a good job making her hateable and making you root for her to go down. So they did a good job with that. There's a scene in here where a bunch of the guards, a bunch of the CEO guards, right? They raided Jaime's house, and his family is still there. And they drag them out. His family is like screaming, like yelling, like, "Hey, get off my daughter, get off my mom," and all that. And they're pointing guns at them and force them to like get on the ground, asking them questions, "Where's Jaime?" and all that. And then later on, Jaime's sister and his dad, they're literally face down on the ground with one of the guards like pointing their guns at their heads. And yeah, that moment, that scene kind of, I felt very uncomfortable watching that scene. I felt very uneasy watching it, because unfortunately shit like that happens in the real world, and unfortunately there's no hero to, there's no superhero to save us. It doesn't just happen to Hispanics, but Black people too. And that scene felt a little too, hit a little too close to home a bit. It kind of hit a little too close, you know. It was kind of I could probably do without it. Like, I get what they were going for. I get the whole themes and what the director was going for when they put the scene in, but still I was like, it's a little, you probably could have eased back a little bit. Like, that kind of hit a little too close. Like, I felt like again, I felt very uncomfortable. I felt very uneasy watching that. So, shit. I go to the movies to escape reality, not to be reminded of reality. And that scene reminded me of reality, and I was like, damn, this is supposed to be a fun superhero movie. Now you got me thinking about real shit, and it's like, oh, damn it. So yeah, if I felt like how my cousin felt when she watched Guardians 3 with all the animal torture scenes, I felt like her watching this, because like, yeah, that, again, that hit a little too close to home a bit. So I feel like they could have held back a little bit, but other than that, like, those are really just kind of nitpicky kind of, but then again, probably not. I don't know. Sorry that I'm all over the place. It's just, that's a very serious topic, and I try it on this channel. I try to keep things light and fun and jokey and all that. So that's that was a very serious topic. So sorry if I'm a little all over the place. But yeah, I feel like they could have eased up on it a little bit. But I see what they were going for, and I see it. But other than that, I will say I really did like the movie. Like I said, it's one of the better DC movies out there. I like the action. I like the characters. I was rooting for the big bad go down, because she was a bitch. The white man. You know, the white man never cares about us. The white man never cares about minorities. You know? The white man. So, or in this case, the white woman. But not the white man. Yeah, they don't care. They don't care. But, so I liked it. I liked it a lot. I liked the action. I liked the characters. I liked the relationship between Jaime and the Scarab. There's a lot to like here. I give it 2 thumbs up. With no J3T stamp of approval. Would... If you have 2 hours to spare, I'd say go watch it. But then again, I wouldn't say, like, hey, get stop what you're doing right now. Go to the theaters and watch Blue Beetle. It's not, like, that type of movie. But if you got 2 hours to kill, you could spend it doing worse. But if you're interested and you don't really want to go out to the theater, I'd say just wait till it goes to Max. Not HBO Max, just Max. But if you got 2 hours to kill, there are worse ways to spend 2 hours. So you won't be... You'll be entertained. So, yeah, that's about it. So, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. But if you really, really, really like me, then consider subscribing and ring that bell so you always know whenever I upload, because it is free. It is free, goddammit. Don't be a dum-dum. Subscribe today. Deuces.